Hello and welcome to another Be Love Tribe All Level Vinyasa Flow class. Today it's a self-love, self-nourishing class. So I'm very happy that you're joining me. Working with me today are some blocks if you have them, or a book. Can also work, of course, blanket if you want to. At the end for Vinyasa, for the Shavasana to cover yourself, or pet your knees if you need to. I have my trusty little sheepskin here, but you can always use a blanket or a pillow. Take whatever props you need to keep yourself comfortable and safe. So if you're looking at the recording, put the recording on hold for a little bit. Get your props and we meet up on the mat again. So first of all, come sitting down in a comfortable position for you. Sitting cross-legged or in hero pose. And maybe you want to raise your hips a little bit. Sitting on a blanket always helps with that. To raise your hips a little bit so your back is a bit straighter. And your knees are lowering down a little bit. And come sit down, close your eyes, and breathe in and out deeply and slowly, arriving on the mat today. Beautiful class with some heart opening, self-love. Beautiful, nourishing time for yourself. I'm going to start with a little breath exercise. This is called the Brahmari breath, or the humming bee breath, because we're going to make a sound that sounds like a humming bee. And the sound, you can feel the vibration in your body. It's also clearing the chakras in the places where you feel it in your body. Depends on how high you make your hum, actually. So if you have a lower hum, you feel it more in your belly. If your voice is a bit higher, you maybe feel it in your chest or in your throat area. So it really depends on what happens for you today, where your voice is and what needs to be cleared. And we'll give a demonstration before we start. So what we do is we breathe in through the nose, deeply, and when we breathe out, we make a humming noise, like when you're humming on a song. So it sounds like this. And you make your out breath as long as possible, breathing totally out, breathing into the nose again, and humming it out. Okay, so let's start. Close your eyes. Breathe in one more time together, in and out. Breathing in. Breathing out. And breathing in for the first hum. Totally in. And start your humming. Mm-hmm. Start your last cycle of breath for your last hum. And come back to your normal breath. Keep your eyes closed. Breathing in a couple of times, in and out, deeply and slowly. See if you can still feel the vibration in your body from the hum. Waking up your body slowly. Relaxing your nervous system. Put your eyes closed, bring your hands together and start to make them warm, rubbing them together, warming up your hands. Already activating your arms a little bit. Make the rubbing a bit more intense. Give it some power. Really warming up the whole hands. And maybe feel your hands are warm enough. Stop the rubbing and place them on your heart. Feel the energy of your warm hands on your heart. Giving yourself some love, some warmth, some nourishing. It's time to set your intention. Maybe you want to let go of something in your heart. Center, or you want to empower something from your heart. Or send some love to somebody, someone, or to the collective. I know that you can take this intention with you throughout your practice, every breath. And every pose, you empower your intention. Feel your body relaxing more and more. Your sit bones sink deeper into the mat. Your shoulders are away from the ears. Jaws relax. Eyes are softly in the sockets, eyelids are closed gently. And the next out breath, slowly let go of your hands, bring them to your knees, and open your eyes. Welcome again. So we're going to begin with warming up slowly by opening up the arms to the side. Spread them out, bring them a little bit back. So you open your chest, open your heart, bring your shoulder blades together, and then bring your right arm under your left and give yourself a hug. So you take hold of your scapula, your shoulder blades with your hands, and give yourself a hug. Bring your chin to the chest. Now maybe you want to roll your neck out a little bit, move your neck, your head in a way that feels nourishing to you. So it's different for everybody. Maybe you want to make half circles. Maybe you want to move up and down your breath. You make a whole circle. See what it is that you need. can either keep your eyes closed or have them open slightly with a soft gaze. And slowly come to stillness. Breathing in, opening up totally again, widening your arms, bring them to the back. Shoulder blades are touching, heart is opening. And exhale, bring your arms back together. Now right over left. So you change your cross and you give yourself a big hug again. The other side, bringing your chin to your chest. Deep breathing to the belly. See if you want to move your neck and your head. Getting all the tension out. Warming up. Slowly. With tenderness and care. And come back to stillness in the middle. Your head to a neutral position. Opening up the arms to the side. And on the next in breath, bring your arms up and overhead. And let your fingertips touch. Lengthen. And on the out breath, bring your arms down. Palms are facing down. And fingertips touch the mat. Inhale, bring your arms all the way up overhead. Fingertips touching up and overhead. Lengthen and on the out breath, bring your arms down, hands down, and hand palms facing down, and then touch your fingertips on the mat. One more time, inhale all the way up. Bring the energy up, fingertips touch. And exhale, bring your hands down. And then your fingertips to the mat. Beautiful. Inhale, bring your arms straight again, alongside your body, alongside the mat. And they're active, straighten out all the way through the fingertips. Strong arms going to warm up the shoulder joint by moving the arms up and down. So you remove your hand palms, palms of your hands up and down. The movement comes all the way from your shoulder joint. So you're opening and closing, opening up on the in-breath, closing on the out-breath. Moving up in the in-breath, hand palms are facing up and moving to hand palms facing down on the out-breath. And keep on moving like this in your own pace, in your own breathing. From the shoulder joint, warming up. Maybe you feel getting tired a little bit, arms are shaking a little bit. It's totally okay, totally natural to happen. Two more times, up, down, up, and down. Good. Now bring your hands towards your shoulders, shoulder joint. And we're going to start making some twists with our torso and rapid breathing. So when we breathe in, we move to the left. And then we breathe out, we move to the right. And we do it with a rapid breath. You see, maybe you start slowly. And you make it a bit faster and a bit more intense, and you feel you warmed up a little bit more. Warming up the spine, keep the spine straight, chin is shut, slightly tucked in. Slowly come to stillness back to the middle again. Good. Breathing out, bring your hands down. Very good. Breathing in, bring your arms back up and cross your left arm over to the right. Take hold of your left arm with your right hand. Shoulders are down. You're going to stretch out the whole left arm by using the strength of your right arm. Just look at the video if you don't understand my words. Your hand of the left arm is relaxed. And you move your right ear towards your right shoulder. So it's a little stretch in the neck also. Keep your spine straight, so don't collapse. Keep your heart open, spine straight. And your right ear moves through your right shoulder. Inhale, come back to neutral. Move your nose towards your left shoulder. And feel stress on the right side. You want to wiggle out the fingers of your left hand. Keep on breathing. Next out breath, let go of the hands. Place your left hand on your right knee. Place your right hand behind you on tended fingertips. Lengthen out in the in-breath and exhale, twist. Move your gaze gently to the back and come into a side twist, gentle warming up side twist. Lengthen with the in-breath and maybe an out-breath. Through your breathing, you twist a little bit deeper. Don't force yourself. Let the breathing do the work. Last in-breath here, and out-breath, move back to the front of the mat. Breathing in, bring your arms up, straight again. Breathing out, bring your right arm now over to the left. Take hold of your right arm with your left hand. Shoulders are away from the ears, and stretch out the whole right arm with your left hand. Use the strength of your left arm. Right hand is relaxed. And out breath, bring your left ear to your left shoulder, stretching out the right side of the neck. You want to move a little bit to see where you feel most stretch. And when you feel the place, stay there. Breathe towards the stretch, all the way down to your base. Inhale, bring your head back to neutral. Move your gaze towards your right shoulder. And stretch out to the left side of your neck. You want to wiggle your right fingers a little bit. Make sure your hand is still relaxed. Last in breath here. And then out breath. Release your hands. Place your right hand on your left knee. Bring your left hand behind you on tended fingertips. Inhale, lengthen through the spine. And exhale, bring your gaze to the back. Side twist to the other side. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, hollow out the belly and see if you can maybe come a little bit deeper in the twist without forcing yourself. Keep on breathing deeply. One last inhale. And exhale, come back to neutral to the front. Good. You can even shake out your hands a little bit, your arms. Nice. You're going to meet up in tabletop position. So stack your wrists underneath your shoulders, the knees, underneath your hips. Knees are hip width distance apart, and your back is straight and neutral. Going to do some cat-cow variation. So breathe in, come into a cow, hollow out your back, bring your nose, draw your nose up towards the ceiling. Exhale, dome your spine and bring your weight to the back. Come into child's pose with your round back. Inhale, bring your weight to the front, hollowing out. Bend the arms and come up for cow. Exhale, dome the spine and move back towards seated position. Child's pose. Keep on moving your own breath, your own pace in this circular cat-cow movement. Breathing in, coming up for cow, hollowing out. Breathing out, doming your spine. Move your weight to the back into a round child's pose. Chin towards the chest. Breathing in, come up for cow, and breathing out for the last cat. Come into your nourishing little cat cave. And breathing in, coming back to neutral. Realign yourself again if you need to. And the next in breath, bring your left arm to the front. Lift your left arm and raise your right leg. Stretch out your fingertips and your leg is straight. Toes are pointing down and your foot is flexed. So you're in one straight line. Everything is stretched out from the heel to your fingertips. Gazes down. Inhale, stretch out. And exhale, bring your elbow towards your knee, rounding down. Inhale, come back. Straighten everything out. And exhale, elbow towards knee, rounding yourself down in a little ball. Keep on moving at your own pace, your own breath. Exhale, rounding down. You can always use your ujjayi breath, your audible ocean breath, to guide yourself through the movements. One more. Inhale, straighten everything out. Hold on. And exhale, plant your hands and your knee back down in tabletop. Moving to the other side. Inhale, bring your right arm up and your left leg up. Toes are pointing down, foot is flexed. Fingertips are spread wide. Stretch out all the way from your heel towards your fingertips. And exhale, bring your elbow towards your knee. Curl up in a little ball. Nose towards the knee. Rounding the spine, inhale, come back, stretching everything out, stretch spine, and exhale, elbow towards knee, nose towards knee, rounding out in a ball, inhale, come back, straighten everything out, keep your hips in one straight line, and exhale, back towards your ball, inhale, straighten everything out. Last time here, hold on, one more breath, and exhale, plant your hands and your knee back to all fours, beautiful. Inhale, curl your toes under, and move the bent knees towards your downward facing dog. Slowly, with awareness, come into your downward facing dog, stretching out through the arms, keep your fingers spread out, push yourself away from all your fingers, strong hands, lots of grip, pushing yourself out of your back, sit bones into the air, and then maybe see if you can straighten out your legs. Walk out your dog a little bit, warming up. See if you can shake your head and nod your head a little bit. Just relax the neck, relax the jaws. Feet are hip distance apart. And come into stillness in your downward facing dog. Take a good deep breath here. Warming up the hamstrings, arm strength, melting the heart open towards the mat. Relax the neck and jaw. Inhale, look towards your hands and step your right foot into your hands, lower down your left knee. Uncurl your toes, and on the next inhale, bring your arms up into a crescent bone. Exhale, bring your arms down, hands down to the mat, throw your left toe under and step back into down facing dog. Inhale, look to the front, take your left knee with you, raise your foot and plant your foot in between your hands, lowering down the right knee, anchor your toes. And the next inhale, bring your arms up into crescent bone, slide back bend, opening the heart, and exhale, bring your hands down towards the mat, stepping back and downward facing dog. Inhale, look to the front. And slowly walk towards the front of the mat. Feet are hip distance apart. Knees are bent as much as you need. Take hold of opposite elbows. Ragdoll. Go with the head. Head is heavy, relaxed. And maybe you want to sway a little bit. From left to right. Back to front. Releasing the back, belly is on top of the thighs, arms are heavy, hands heavy. The next exhale, release the hands, and inhale, vertebra, come up, roll up towards standing position. Hands are from the heart. Tadasana. Mountain pose. Check your alignment. Feet are hip distance apart. Weight is equally divided in all four corners of the feet. Legs are active. Kneecaps are lifted. Tailbone is tucked in slightly. Chin is tucked in slightly. The whole spine is straight. Inhale, bring your arms up and overhead. Take hold of your right wrist with your left hand. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, twist or stretch out towards the left side. Stretch all right side of the body. Inhale, come back up. Switch hands. Next inhale, lengthen, and exhale, bend over to the right side, stretching the whole left side of the body. Inhale, come up, and exhale, release all the way down, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, and exhale, step towards your plank. Next, exhale, knees down, And curl your toes in one straight line. Move down all the way, nose to the mat. Widening your legs a little bit. Feet are a little bit wider than your hips. Bring your hands towards your face. Coming up for baby cobra on the next inhale. Moving up slowly. Gaze slightly down, forward. And you weigh this from your hands. So maybe you want to lift your hands to make sure you have no weight in your hands. Shoulders away from the ears. Baby cobra. Exhale, come down. And move to all fours. And exhale. Back to downward facing dog. Inhale, bring your right leg up. Hips bend straight. Point the toes are pointing down. And exhale, step your right foot in between your hands, lowering down the left knee. And inhale, come up for crescent moon. Take hold of your right wrist with your left hand. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, bend over slightly to the left side to lengthen, stretch out the right side. Inhale, come up. Change your hands. Next inhale, lengthen. And exhale, stretch out to the right side, stretching out the whole left side of the body. Next inhale, come up and exhale, hands come down towards the mat. Bring your weight to the back, stretching out the right leg, flexing your foot, coming into Adho Hanuman. Stretch the whole back of your right leg. Gaze is towards your right knee. Keep on breathing. And then exhale, bring weight back towards your right leg, front. Throw your toes in and step towards plank. Exhale, knees down, uncurl your toes and come lying down in one straight line. Opening up your legs a little bit, place your hands next to your face. And inhale, come out for baby cobra. The weight is from the hands, shoulders away from the ears. Neck is in one straight line with the whole spine. Exhale, bring your nose down. Inhale, move to tabletop to all fours and exhale back to downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg is up. Hips are straight. Toes are pointing down, foot is flexed. And inhale, bring your knee towards your chest. Place your foot in between your hands. Right knees come down and curl your toes. Now inhale, move up. Crescent moon. Take hold of your left wrist with your right hand. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, bend over to the right side, stretching out the whole left side of the body. Your shoulders away from the ears. Your heart stays open. Inhale, come back up. Change hands. Next inhale, lengthen. And exhale. To the other side, stretching out the right side of the body. Bending over to the left. Inhale, come back up. And exhale, arms are moving down towards the mat. And bring your weight to the back, stretching out your whole left leg, flexing your foot, and coming into Adho Hanuman. And on the other side, stretching out the whole back of the left leg. Gaze is towards the left knee. Back is straight. Breathing to the belly. Long, gentle, nourishing, breathing in and out. Next inhale, bring your weight back to the front and step towards your plank. And exhale, bring your knees down, uncurl the toes and come down in one straight line. Opening up the legs again, place your hands this time underneath your shoulders for full cobra. Keep your elbows tucked to next to your body so they're not flailing out. You're keeping towards your ribs. And then inhale, move out of your hands into cobra. Keep your pelvic floor on the mat, shoulders away from the ears, strong arms. And the nose is drawn up ever so slightly. So your whole neck and spine are in one beautiful curve. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, come up to all fours. And exhale, leading up in downward facing dog. Now look to the front. And walk to the front of the mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, come all the way up. Arms dropping overhead. And exhale, hands in front of the heart. Prayer pose. And bring the feet together. If the toes are touching, knees are glued together, heels are maybe a little bit apart. And inhale, bring your arms up. And then exhale, bend your knees. The weight is coming back towards the heels a little bit, coming into Utkatasana, chair pose. Leg is straight. Tailbone is stuck in a little bit, so we're not collapsing in the back, but you keep our spine straight, strong. Arms are strong alongside the ears, Utkatasana. Good. On the next inhale, bring your hands towards your heart. Bend in a little bit deeper and bring your right elbow on your left knee. And on the next exhale, push yourself out of your hands in towards a side twist, Utkatasana side twist. Make sure your knees are next to each other, not flailing out one or the other, just keep them glued together. And keep on breathing. Gazes to straight in front of you. Or maybe you want to look up a little bit. See what happens with your neck if you do that. Choose wisely. The next exhale, look down towards your knees. And the next inhale, pick up your right foot and step it all the way back into a high lunge. So lengthen out your body on the inhale, the exhale. Next exhale, come into the twist again, pushing yourself out of your hands. High lunge, side twist. Make sure your left knee is stacked beautifully on top of your ankle, so your knee is protected. Both legs are active, strong. With every out-breath, hollow out your belly, emptying it out so you can get more into the twist. Maybe you want to stay here. Maybe you want to even put your hand on the floor and put your left hand all the way up for an extended side twist. Keep your heart open. Maybe you want to use your block. It's a bit too far for you. Use your block or your book. There's no shame in that. It's only wise to use whatever you need to get in the best alignment for your body. Everybody's different. Some people have long arms, some people have short arms, long legs, short legs, different torso. So it's all depending also on your body shape, where you can go. Exhale, look down, bring your hands down, and step into plank. Exhale, move to your vinyasa, so either bring your knees down and come lying all the way down, or chaturanga, upward facing dog, meaning up and downward facing dog, or knees down, lie down, cobra. Choose your option. Meeting up in downward facing dog. And know you can always skip your vinyasa, come to child's pose whenever you need it. Listen to your body, what you need right now. Inhale, look to the front, step, walk, or jump to the front of the mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale with bent knees, come up through your Utkatasana. Hold on, see if you can still see your toes, otherwise bring your weight a little bit back towards your heels. One more breath out. And next in-breath, bring yourself all the way up, straighten your legs, and breathing out, bring your hands in front of your heart. Good. Collect your breath. Maybe you want to sigh it out a little bit before you move in to the other side. Breathing in with your arms up and overhead. Lengthening out the body, breathing out, bend your knees, bring your weight to the back. Hands, arms are staying next to the ears, coming into your Utkatasana. Knees are glued together. The toes are touching. Strong legs. This is most people the nicest. Some people actually prefer to have their legs in hip-width distance apart. If that works better for you, of course do that. Choose your option. But if you have your feet together and your knees together, it's a bit more easy for most people. So choose your option. Exhale, bring your hands towards your heart. Bend a little bit deeper. Bring your left elbow to your right knee. Lengthen out of an inhale and exhale. Come into the side twist. Push away through your hands, strong arms, strong legs. Twist in your body in Utkatasana, side twist. Keep on breathing. See if you want to have your gaze straight or maybe you want to look up a little bit. See what works best for you. Maybe you want to challenge yourself a little bit, maybe you don't. Keep in mind, this is a nourishing self-love practice, self-acceptance, where you are today. It's all good. It's an exploration. No judgment on what happens or doesn't happen, what's available for you today. Exhale, look down. And next inhale, pick up your left leg and step it all the way back into a high lunge, side twist. Good. Keep your legs active, beautifully powerful legs. Make sure your knee is stacked directly above your ankle to protect your knee, your right knee. Keep on twisting. Maybe you want to stay here, maybe you want to let go of your hands, move your left hand down, maybe on the block, maybe on the floor. On the inhale, draw your right hand all the way up, your arm all the way up, into an extended side twist. Gaze can be towards the thumb, towards the ceiling or straight. Maybe you're wobbling a little bit, I know I am. Keep on breathing. Last deep breath in here. And exhale, gaze down, bring your hands to the floor. Step back towards your plank. And move through your vinyasa. So either knees are lying in cobra or come into the chaturanga, upward facing dog. Being up in downward facing dog. Beautiful. Take a moment here to collect your breath. Maybe you want to stay in downward facing dog. Maybe you want to come down into child's pose for a little rest. Calm down, breath. Calm down your heart rate. Giving yourself some love. Wherever you are in the moment. Breathing deep into the belly. One more deep breath in and out here. Inside out. And then let's think about yourself up. Meeting up in downward facing dog. Good. The next inhale, bring your left leg up, three-legged dog. Hips are straight. Foot is flexed and toes are pointing down. And the next exhale, bring your weight front, knee towards the chest. Bring your knee, right knee to the left elbow. Inhale, bring your leg back up and three-legged dog. Exhale, weight forward, hug your knee towards your chest and keep your knee hugging towards your chest in the middle. And inhale, back to the three-legged dog. Last time, exhale, bring your knee towards your chest. Bring your weight forward and bring your knee, right knee towards your left, right elbow. Hover for a little bit. And then bring your left and right foot to your left hand and bring your knee down, coming into your pigeon pose. So it depends on your anatomy, the circulation of your knee joint and your hip joint, where your foot is. So maybe your foot is closer towards your left hand, maybe it's closer towards your groin area. It really depends on your anatomy. So find your position, make sure your knee is not pinching, your right knee is not hurting. Straighten out the whole left leg. And if your right hip is not on the floor, take a blanket or a block and you can place that underneath your hip bone on the right side so you're totally supported. Coming up for pigeon. Modified pigeon, actually. If this is still too much for you, you can always come into the deer pose by bending both legs. See what you need today. Coming out of your pigeon, straightening out the back, slide back bend. Inhale, looking up, draw your nose towards the ceiling. Keep your right foot flexed to protect your right knee. And then next exhale, walk yourself down towards your sleeping pigeon. Either with your forehead on the floor, maybe on your hands or a book. Or if it's too much for you, you can always come on your arms, your forearms. See what you need today. to come into your sleeping pigeon, so you can surrender to the pose as much as possible. Letting go of all the muscles, opening up your pelvic area, your hips. Letting go of all the tension in the arms, the neck and jaw. Breathing towards your pelvic area. Deep down to your base. And anytime you feel some pinching in your knee, you can always come up a little bit. Get some weight up of your knee joint. And if you're fine here, stay as still as possible to really surrender. And surrender to the fascia, let the fascia stretch out. Removing light fuzz between your joints, sort of white plaque that accumulates there overnight when you're moving not so much and being still. And it's what makes us stiff. So it's really good to come into these deep stretches, take the time to let go of that white fuzz, that plaque. Melted, so to speak. Last deep inhale and exhale here. And then next inhale, walk yourself gently, slowly all the way up, removing any props. Curl your left toes under again and stepping back into downward facing dog. Find your alignment here. Feel a difference between your left leg and your right leg. Is there a pigeon on one side? The next inhale, lift your left leg up. Keep your hips straight. Foot is flexed and toes are pointing down. Next exhale, bring your chest, your knee towards your chest, and moving forward, bring your left knee towards your right elbow. Inhale, coming back in, three-legged dog. And exhale, moving forward, bring your knee to your chest, bring your knee towards the middle and hover there, in the middle. And inhale, come back into three-legged dog. Last one, exhale, bring your knee to your chest. And then bring your left knee to your left elbow. Hover a little bit longer. And exhale, bring your left foot towards your right hand, lowering down your knee. You're coming into pigeon on the other side. So again, find your position, keep your left foot flexed to protect your knee, straighten out your whole right leg, see where you need to position your foot so your knee is protected. Use your blanket or your block under your left hip bone this time if it's not on the floor, so you're totally supported, and come up for your modified pigeon. And again, this side, you can also bend both knees into deer pose. If it's too much for you to be in full pigeon. Inhale, looking up. Knee or nose drawn towards the ceiling. Slide, heart opening. And exhale, melt down, bring yourself all the way down towards your sleeping pigeon. Use a block, or not. Maybe your board is on the mat, maybe you have a block, maybe you're staying on your forearms. See what you need today. Maybe this side is different than the other side. It is for me. So I'm staying on my forearms here. If you're on your forearms, let go of your head. Your head is heavy. Relax as much muscles as you can. And if you find your position, stay as still as you can to render the fascia towards the stretch. Melting all the white fast, the black away. Moving the stiffness out of all those areas. You build up the black during the night. Breathing towards your pelvic area, your hip joints. Nourishing your whole body by surrendering as much as you can. Keep on breathing. Use your Ujjayi breath, your Ocean breath. Helps you warming up your body even more. Melting even more. Last deep in and out breath here. And on the next deep breath, slowly walk yourself up. Stepping back into downward facing dog. Stretching yourself out. The last time here. Feel how your legs are feeling now, the same or still different. Feel into your body. In the next exhale, bring your knees down. Come sitting down with your legs in front of you. Feet are on the floor. Knees are in the air, with your arms straight for you, in front of you, and with active abdominal muscles, slowly, vertebra by vertebra, move all the way down. Towards the supine position, lying down. Yeah. I'm going to lie all the way up on your back. The whole back is straight on the floor and move your feet as close to your sit bones as possible so you can touch your heels with your fingertips. You're going to move into a bridge. Keep your knees in hip width distance apart. Bend your hand palms on the mat. And inhale, bring your pelvic floor up. And your chest is moving towards your chin, telescoping out your chest. Pressing your feet into the floor, keeping your head straight. Coming into bridge pose. that your knees are not flailing out. They're strong and active, sort of pushing towards each other. Keep on breathing. Couple breaths in bridge pose. Try to keep your pelvic floor lifted as much as you can. And next exhale, come down, vertebra, vertebra, slowly towards the floor, opening up your feet as wide as the mat and bring your knees towards each other for constructive rest in between. Couple of breaths here to realign again. And moving back into your bridge position. And maybe only if you have a block, it's not so good to do with a book because it maybe collapse and it will be dangerous. So if only if you have a real yoga block, you can do this. Otherwise, you go back into the next bridge, same as you did. But if you have a block, you can also do a supported bridge. So move yourself in your position. Your fingertips are touching your heels. And you move your hands in towards the mat. On the next inhale, bring your pelvic floor up, moving into bridge, maybe even bring your shoulders a little bit away from or next to each other together. You can bring your hands, clasp them together, and moving out of your bridge a little bit higher like this. So you're really pressing out of your hands underneath your buttocks, or you take your block, come on your tippy toes. Place your block underneath your sacrum. The block is with the long side straight with the top of the mat. And you are in your highest position of the block. And you move into a more restorative bridge pose. So if you have a block, you can try this. Stay here, relax the body and breathe. Or you come into the same bridge you first did. So it's a little bit of a less hybrid, or bring your hands interlaced underneath your sit bones and push yourself out of your arms, squeezing your shoulder blades together and push a little bit deeper into the bridge. So you can choose whatever option feels best to you now, what gives you the most nourishment, maybe a little bit more active, maybe a little bit more restorative. And keep on breathing. You can always move back a little bit if it's too much. Breathing into your pelvic area. Pressing out of your foot, your feet. Or surrendering to your restorative bridge on the block. Last in-breath here, deep in-breath. And the next out breath, release your hands or release your block underneath you and move all the way down. Great. Bring your knees towards your chest, bring your feet into the air. Take hold of your foot and bring yourself into a happy baby pose. So your knees are coming towards your armpits. You press your feet towards towards the floor, and the soles of the feet are pointing up towards the sky. This is too much for you. You can always take hold of your thighs. Make sure the whole back is on the floor, from your neck towards the sacrum, releasing the back bend. You want to move a little bit, sway a little bit from left to right. Massaging the back on the mat, and maybe you stay still. Breathing through the belly, all the way down to the lowest point of your back. Sigh it out. Good. Release your foot. Bring your knees together. Place your hands in your knee pits, in the back of your knees. And roll yourself up and down to the back and to the front with a round spine. And come towards the seated position. Good. Stretching out the legs. Shake them out a little bit. Give them some shaking, some moving, before we move into our forward fold. Bring your feet into a diamond shape. Feet are together. Knees are flailing out. And your knees are away from your pelvic floor as much as your hands are stretching out. You can still touch your toes. So measure yourself up. Maybe if you've done that, you can give your feet a little bit of a rub. Give them some love. Very well. Become stillness. Get all of your foot. Breathing in, lengthening out the whole spine. And exhale, hinge from the hips forward until you can't get any further around a straight spine. When you're there, just rounding down with the head hanging heavy, coming to your forward fold without stretching yourself or forcing anything, just like gravity. Move you into this forward fold, rounding down the whole back. Opening up the hips. Jaws relaxed. Tongue is soft in the mouth. Eyes are gently closed. Arms are relaxed. Legs are heavy and knees are falling down on their own, without any force. Breathing into the belly, into the pelvic area. Maybe breathing all the way down to your feet. Nourishing your whole body, new energy, every in-breath. And letting go of any toxicity with every out breath. If you can relax your body even more with every outbreath, going towards the end of this practice you've done so beautifully today. Giving your body the love it needs, nourishment. Release all tension. Last deep in and out breath here. And then your next in breath, walk yourself up ever so gently. Maybe scoot yourself over a little bit down on the mat and keep your knees to the outside and gently. Vertebra by vertebra, move towards your back in a butterfly position, lying on your back, opening up the hips to a supine butterfly. Last pause before we go into Savasana. Maybe you want to take some blocks or some pillows underneath your knees. If there's too much pinching going on in the hip area, sometimes it happens. If we are here, lying down on a butterfly with opening hips, with the hip socket and the ball of the hip will touch, so it's bone-to-bone compression and give some pinching. So if you elevate your knees a little bit, it can help release the pinching sensation. So see what you need. Take care of your body. When you find your position, surrender there. Let go of all the tension in the back, shoulders, neck, jaw. Legs are heavy. Feet are relaxed. Maybe have your eyes closed to a soft gaze. You like to place your hands down on your belly, one on your belly and one on your heart. Deep breaths in and out. Very vulnerable position, so open. Opening your hips, opening your soft tissue in the belly, opening the heart. This is a truly courageous, vulnerable position to be in. So you can acknowledge yourself for doing that, for opening up so bravely all that is you in this moment. Maybe you feel some energy moving through your body, some emotion, some tension, some thoughts. It's all okay, just let it happen. Let it be. Surrender. Always place a hand on the belly or the heart to give yourself some protection, some safety. Some warmth and some nourishment. Last deep in out breath here. Maybe you want to side out. Release your legs into blocks or drops away if you use them. Stretching out the legs, coming into your last alternate resting pose, Savasana. You want to put on some socks, please do so. Cover yourself up with a blanket to keep yourself warm and also to keep the energy in. Just move into the body, the energy that you collected in the body. The heaviness of the blanket helps with the integration of all that happened and didn't happen today in your practice. When you found your total, final, relaxed pose, stay as still as possible. The full integration of all happened today. Breathe deep into the belly. And feel yourself sinking deeper and deeper into the mat. Every out-breath. Totally resting on Mother Earth, carrying you always, who has your back, who carries your heart, safe, with infinite, unconditional love for you, just as you are. You can stay here as long as you want in this integration. Maybe some stuff came up for you today, some feelings, some emotion. You need some more time to be here. Please take care of yourself and stay here as long as you need. And for now, I want to say thank you so much for being here with me. This practice, taking this time for yourself, showing up for yourself, honoring yourself. Thank you so much. Namaste. Satnam.